everyone. So this weekend was supposed to be our show weekend. And I know that it can be a bit of a bummer to think about where we were planning to be versus where we are now. And honestly, it's okay to feel sad about that. But remember that the arts are more important now than ever. It's easy to dismiss the arts at a time like this. But without the arts, how else could we express ourselves and share our stories and our experiences? So at Holy Family Drama Club, we are very excited to continue our journey with you guys and continue to share and tell our stories together. I look forward to working with all of you guys again very, very soon. So stay healthy, stay positive, we'll get through this together. Liz here. I just wanted to say that I am so proud of all of you. Thank you for putting all of this time and effort into rehearsing for this year's show. I am heartbroken and devastated that you're not able to perform it this weekend, as I'm sure you are too. But just know this, the show must go on. This is not the end for you. I want you to reflect on your time with musical theater at Holy Family, especially for you 8th graders. It's been amazing watching you guys grow as into the wonderful young performers that you are, and I hope that you reflect on what all of the wonderful experiences that you've had, making friendships, learning how to sing, learning how to act and dance. It's all wonderful, and I encourage you to keep doing it in the future, especially if you go off to high school and you love theater, keep doing it. I'm thinking of you this weekend. We are all thinking of you this weekend. I hope that maybe you blast speechless and sing as loudly as you can to it, perform whatever your favorite song is from the show for your parents, and just enjoy your weekend. I hope that you all are safe and healthy, and hopefully we will see you all very soon. Take care. Bye. You what I'm working with? Well, Alibaba, he had them 40 thieves. Shahrazad, he had 1,000 tails. But Master, you're in luck, because up your sleeve, you got a brand of magic never fails. You got some power in your corner now, heavy ammunition in your camp. You got some punch, pizzazz, and how? All you gotta do is rub that lamp, and then I'll say, Mr. Man, what's your name? Whatever, what will your pleasure be? Let me take your order, I'll jot it down. You ain't never had a friend like me. Life is your restaurant, and I'm your maitre d'. Come whisper to me whatever it is you want. You ain't never had a friend like me. We pride ourselves on service. You the boss, the kid in the shop. Say what you wish, it's yours, true dish. How about a little more baklava? Have some of column A, try all of column B. I'm in the mood to help you, dude. You ain't never had a friend like me. Oh! This the big part. Watch out! This the big part. Oh! Can your friends do this? Can your friends do that? Can your friends pull this out of their little hat? Can your friends go? The lamb. I can sing rap dance if you give me a chance. Oh! Don't sit there buggy-eyed. I'm here to answer all your midday prayers. You got me bona fide certified. Got a genie for your charge d'affaires. I got a powerful urge to help you out. So what you
Hi, everybody. It's been a long time since I've seen a lot of you, and for that I'm really sad. But I did want to send out a little message of motivation to help you get through everything that we're dealing with. I think the trick to really living your life well and growing up and finding out who you are and pursuing what makes you tick, I think it has a lot more to do with acknowledging what you've lost and getting excited that every day then is a new opportunity. You have to look at the days like it's another opportunity to do something that you love. And it might be learning a monologue, or learning a song, or jamming in the shower. Or it could be, you know, hugging your dog for extra long, or telling someone that you appreciate them. I think the lesson is to adapt. And I think that you have to start seeing what you do have control over in your life. You have control over how you approach the day. You have control over what you do in a day. You have control over how you speak to people. And you have to focus on all of the good things that you do have, okay? So change the narrative. The trick is, even in quarantine, it's important to make art. You have to do what makes you tick. You have to embrace the moment. And you have to keep learning. You have to keep adapting. You have to keep taking care of yourself, and you have to see the good. Love you guys. I'll talk to you later. I can't wait to see you all and see what amazing things you're going to do in the next couple months. And I hope against hope that I will be able to be a part of that. So great. Okay. Love you all. Have a great one. Bye.
From a land, from a faraway place, where the caravan camels roam. Where it's flat and immense, and the heat is intense. It's barbaric, but hey, it's home.
When the wind's from the east,
and the sun's from the west,
and the sand in the glass is right.
Come on down,
stop on by,
hop a carpet and fly
to another Arabian night.
Agrabah is famous for, right? The lamp! Don't be fooled by its commonplace appearance. Like so many things, it is not what is outside, but what is inside that counts.
Arabian Nights! Arabian Nights!
You see, Agrabah is a city where a penniless nobody can turn out to be a noble somebody. Even if his pals are as thick as thieves.
Arabian Nights!
Agrabah is a place where a princess would give up her crown for true love. Except that her father, the Sultan, is a stickler for the ancient ways.
Arabian Nights!
Here, it's wise to watch your step, for danger lurks around every corner. But, most importantly, Agrabah is a place where everybody sings!
Hello everyone, it's Rick Kerner here, your sound guy. I was really looking forward to doing the show with you. I'm proud of all of you, and I'm glad I get a chance to at least celebrate with you now. I was hoping to show you some great sound effects that I was ready to put into the show. I had some beautiful, warm sounds for Aladdin and Jasmine. And Charlie, I was gonna help make the carpet fly. And maybe even some sounds for Raja. Ooh, that's not good. Well, anyway, to help you celebrate, here's what I'm going to do for you. I'm going to put on my own mic. So here's to all of you. Good job, everybody.
On your block to meet his eye. Make way, here he comes. Ring bells, bang the drums. You're gonna love this guy, Prince Ali. Fabulous, he Ali Ababwa. Show some respect, boy, genuflect. Down on one knee. Now try your best to stay calm. Brush up your Friday salon. Then come and meet his spectacular coterie. Strong as 10 regular men, definitely. He's faced a galloping horde, 100 bad guys with swords. Who sent those crews to their lord?
My Prince Ali.
Fellas, he's got
75 golden
pounds. Now the ladies, what he got?
People is why he got all cute and dropped by.